So in this session, we will see the food preservative. As we know, the food is easily spoiled due to growth of microorganism. So to control the spoilage of food, we should prevent the growth of microorganism. So the food preservative, it is prevent and retard the microbial spoilage in the food. So food preservatives are the stop microbial growth in the food. So as we commonly use food preservatives like common salt, sugar or glucose. So food preservatives are two classes. Class first, natural preservative. Class second, chemical preservative. In class first, we use common salt, sugar, glucose, vinegar, honey, onion, spices. These are all the food preservative. And class second, we use benzoic acid and its salt or benzoate. This is the preservative. Next, tartarate, the salts of potassium tartarate or sodium tartarate we use as a preservative, and also sodium disitate. So we will see the how to analyze or how to estimate the food preservative in our food. So the FSSAI or standard food authority, it has a at a specific level we add the food preservative in our food. If the quantity is higher, there it may be causes to danger our health. So estimation of preservative. First, benzoic acid. So benzoic acid, it is add the preservative in jam, jelly, sauces and beverages, wines. So the benzoic acid, first we will see the qualitative test for benzoic acid. So by using FeCl3, we detect the benzoic acid is present, the preservative in the food. So for this, the process is first sample, first extraction of benzoic acid by using ether as a solvent. So for this, first we take a sample plus HCl 1:3%. Then this sample plus HCl put in separating funnel. So on the separating funnel, we add ether as a solvent, organic solvent, for using the separation of benzoic acid in that food. So after extraction or collected the benzoic acid and solvent in the beaker, so after filtration we evaporate the solvent and add 0.5 FeCl3 in PPT. It shows the salmon color PPT, that is the presence of benzoic acid. So second method, this is the qualitative method. Second, quantitative method. For quantitatively, we detect benzoic acid by three quantitative method. First, titration method. Second, spectrophotometric method. Third, by HPLC method. So by titration method, we will, after the first extraction process, extraction by ether, and this extracted sample we titrate it with NaOH, that is a strong base. So after that titration, we detect the quantity of benzoic acid present in that food sample. Next, by spectrophotometric method. In the spectrophotometric method, first we extract the benzoic acid sample in given food sample. After extraction, we will detect at UV spectrophotometry at 272 nanometer absorbance. By using the standard benzoic acid solution against this unknown, we got the quantity of benzoic acid present in that food. Next process, HPLC. So after extraction, here extraction by ether, then this extracted are passed to HPLC for separation. Here we use the vacuum separation or other Buckner filtration. Here we use the HPLC separation. After separation by HPLC, they run, and then we by add in UV spectrophotometer, check at 272 nanometer. So we detect the concentration of benzoic acid in the food. Next preservative, we will see the diethyl carbonate. Generally in wines, this diethyl carbonate is useful. So diethyl, for the diethyl carbonate extraction by using carbon disulfide, and after extraction by using carbon disulfide, it passed to gas chromatography. Thus we separated diethyl carbonate. For this, we will take 100 ml of sample in separating funnel and 20 ml of carbon disulfide. So in separating funnel there are two layers. So lower layer it is collected on test tube and it's centrifuge, and after centrifuge we will take 1 microliter of this sample and pass to GC for separation. And next we'll see the aspartame. So for the qualitative analysis, we use the TLC, and quantitative we use SPLC and UV for aspartame preservative. So for qualitative analysis, we use the TLC. For the base prepare TLC, we use by using silica gel, and the solvent for using TLC, methanol plus acetic acid, 80 by 20%. For this aspartame, we check with the standard solution 0.05, 0.1, 0.15, 0.20 and 0.25. So first we run TLC by the standard solution, and then by unknown solution. Also by quantitatively, by using separation of aspartame by using HPLC, and after separation by using the UV spectrophotometer, we can determine the aspartame. So this is the small information about food preservative.